cold outside, but the fire keeps us warm. We can spend the night underneath the mist.
Well, hey friends, welcome back. And if you're new, I want to welcome you today. I appreciate you stopping by. And guys, I'm so excited because I'm doing a video with DIY treats for the holiday season. And I will be co-hosting this with Miss Betty from No Place Like Home with Miss Betty. Now, she asked me to help her host. This is her first time hosting. So please, I'll leave her link for her channel in the description bar below. I would love for you to stop by, show us some love, and say that Lady Cinnamon sent you. And guys, she does home decor, tablescapes, DIYs, home improvement, upcycling of furniture, and cooking on her channel, and she does it with such joy in everything she does. I guarantee you, you will not be disappointed if you do subscribe. So guys, for my first DIY treat, I will be doing some cake pops. First thing I'm going to do is just mix it and get it in the oven because I really want this to cook down while I prepare the other treats so I can multitask. That's great for the holidays, multitasking. So we'll get back to this once they get done and cooled. For my first treat, I'm going to be doing some chocolate covered pretzels. They are a good mainstay and they're super easy and quick. All you have to do is pick up pretzel rods. I'm going to be using some Ghirardelli chocolate. I know a lot of people use the candy melts. Guys, this works so much better and it tastes a million times better. And this is the good stuff. So all you have to do is add it in a bowl, a little bit of oil, pop it in the microwave for about a minute, stir it, you're good to go. And like I said, it works so much better. Now I'm going to be adding this into a taller cylinder glass. I will show you why. This is a very easy trick for coating these and it's so quick and easy. It's a great fun trick to do with your kids. And the tip is just dipping it in that glass because of the shape and putting it on parchment paper. Always remember to use the parchment paper when your chocolate is setting up and I guarantee you it will not stick. So I hope that helps. So I'm just gonna pop these in the fridge for about 2 or 3 minutes till it sets up and I'm going to go ahead and decorate them. Now I got these from the grocers in the baking aisle. I just mixed them together well and I'm just going to drizzle them. However, while they're still wet, you can add like nuts or maybe M&Ms and they're so fun and festive. Now I'm gonna be using green and red because it's for the holiday, but I can imagine doing all of these treats that I'm going to be doing today for maybe a baby shower in blue or pink, or for like an Easter or Valentine's Day, and so many other occasions. And as you can see, all I'm doing is drizzling these in the red and green for the holiday colors. They look so pretty, and this is such a quick, easy DIY treat, and it's a crowd pleaser. Everyone loves the combination of salt and sweet, and it's amazing. And this was so quick. This took all of about 10 minutes. And I even put them in the packaging and they look awesome. So I'm off to my next DIY treat for the holidays. So for the next one, I'm going to be doing some chocolate covered Oreos. Oh my God, they're so good, guys. And make sure if you're gonna try this that you do get the double stuffed ones, and I'm going to show you why. You want the cream to be really thick. You're just gonna separate them. And I'm gonna be using a cake pop for these. You definitely want it to be thick enough for the double stuff so you can insert the cake pop and then add the other piece for the cookie on. And as you can see, that's how you form your pop. And isn't that easy, guys? I love this one. It's so simple. I'm going to be using the same chocolate that I had, and I'm also going to be doing these in the white chocolate also. Once again, adding them to the parchment paper so they will not stick, and getting them in the fridge for a few minutes. Now for this one, before I put them in the fridge to set up for a few minutes, I actually picked up some sprinkles. I really wanted to have all of my treats very festive for the holiday season. And guys, I got these in the grocery store also. Now, you can pick these up in any craft store in the baking aisle. They were sold out at every one I went, so apparently everybody's baking this year. So I went ahead and added on my sprinkles. I think they look so festive, and it just reminds me of holiday baking, and it's just so much fun when you do it with family. And guys, you gotta try this, and look how beautiful they looked. Awesome, awesome, awesome. They came out so pretty. And the good thing is they don't have to be perfect, but it's so much fun to bake with family for the holidays. And trust me, these were a hit and a crowd pleaser. So for the next one, I had some leftover jumbo marshmallows. It rained so much this fall that I didn't even get to use them. So I will be adding these in with my treats. Very simple and easy. All you have to do is the same process. Add the cake pop stick and stick them into the actual chocolate. And guys, this was really quick. This was just as quick as the pretzels. And before they set up, I went ahead and coated some in the milk chocolate and others in the white chocolate. And then I just sprinkled a little bit of my sprinkles onto like a little saucer, dipped them in and put them to the side. This was so quick and easy and so much fun. People just love marshmallows. I think they make people happy. So for my next one, I'm going to be getting out my cake. Now it's baked and it's all ready, and I'm just gonna put it in a large bowl and just break it up into little pieces. And guys, this is so simple. Now, I don't have a cake pop pan, and if you have one and you bake them, they're really great, but this is what you could do in the meantime if you don't have one. This is how I make them, and I'm just gonna be adding icing to the cake that's already done, and I'm just gonna mix it really well. Now, I will say that these make the cake pops a little dense. So I have a trick for dense cake pops so they don't fall off while you're trying to coat them with the chocolate. But the first things first, we definitely want to mix this really well and get it into the fridge to set up. And I'm going to be making cake pop balls. Now guys, I know I could not find my ice cream scoop, so I am just using what I have and going with the flow. So much fun, just so relaxing. And the trick to this is just make sure that your hands are a little damp, not wet, but a little damp, so this mixture does not stick to your hands. And that's my tip for making these. Now, once you get these in the fridge and back out, they're going to be a little dense, so the trick to get around that is to coat your pops, your cake pop sticks rather, and just dip them in the chocolate and then put them on top of your cake pop and insert them. And they're already cold, so they'll set up really fast. And the purpose of this is to make it nice and sturdy for when you go to dip them in the chocolate, because like I said, these are a little bit more dense and they're very weighted. But the upside to that is that they taste amazing and they have so much more flavor than a regular cake pop. Once you have them set, you're gonna go ahead and dip them, and you don't have to worry about them being so heavy with the weight of the chocolate that they fall off the pop. So that's a really great tip if you're gonna be trying this. Now for these, I know they're a little flat on top. I purposely did not make them too round, and I will show you why. I really wanted to decorate these and make these really over the top and festive for the holiday season. I'm definitely going to be making some more of these throughout the season. And while these are ready to set up, I'm going to show you now why I did not go through the process of making sure they weren't flat. I wanted them flat. I have my sprinkles already. They've already set up in the fridge, and now I'm ready to start really decorating these because I want to make these really pretty. So I'm just going to dip them into the chocolate, just get, you know, wipe off the excess, and then dip it into the sprinkles. And guys, do you see how pretty that is? Now you see why I wanted the top to be sort of flat. And I absolutely love the way this is turning out. They look so pretty that you don't even want to eat them. And it looks like you might have gotten these from one of those confectioner shops that you see. And just so much fun. And to really take this to the next level, I'm going to drizzle this with some chocolate. And as you can see, for a contrast, for the white pops, I'm using the darker chocolate and vice versa, and it really looks so amazing. And guys, it's so simple. I know it looks difficult, but if I can do this, trust me, you can do it too. And it was so relaxing. So for some of them, I actually used both of the colors and drizzled them to give it like a marble effect. And it's so pretty. And nobody could believe that I actually did these, but yeah, I did. And it was so much fun and a definite crowd pleaser. And I love the way they turned out. So I packaged them all in these little clear packages. I picked this up from Amazon. I can leave this kit in the description bar below if you're interested in purchasing it. It comes with everything you need, the sticks, the cake pop sticks, the twists, and actually the clear bags also. And they are perfect for packaging these. They would be great if you want to give them as baked goods as a present, or maybe for something that you're, you know, a party that you're going to. They're perfect for giveaways or favors, and I think they're so beautiful. And you can even add a ribbon to it and really make it festive. So Miss Betty asked that we use these treats to decorate or use at our coffee bar. So I definitely wanted to let you guys see how I use them. They were perfect for the holiday and everybody loved them so much. They would go get one of these as a treat and make themselves something hot to drink, like hot cocoa tea or coffee. And it was so much fun and they loved them. So I do want to thank you, Miss Betty. I really felt so honored being your first person that you picked to host with. I can't thank you enough. So thank you for being such a gracious host. Please don't forget to check out her channel, and I will leave her information in the description bar below. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and also hit the bell twice so you'll be notified whenever I upload more cooking videos or just regular DIYs, because you guys know I love crafting. And I'm going to be doing a couple of more decorating videos for the holiday season. So look forward to seeing those. And I want to thank you all for watching.